Okay, welcome, gentlemen. Today we're going to look at the balance sheets. So the balance sheet, by definition, it reflects how much a business is worth at the end of a time period. So at the end of February, you can tell me how much a business is worth by looking at the balance sheets. So the balance sheet uses the accounts from the balance sheet's account section. So remember when you think of the trial balance and when you did the trial balance, it had the balance sheet section at the top and the nominal section at the bottom. So the balance sheet uses the accounts that we would put in the trial balance on the balance sheet section. So these accounts include things like assets, liabilities, capital, drawings. So it shows the financial position of the business on a specific day. So basically, you can tell me how our business is financially at the end of February, the 28th of February. Can tell me that the financial position of our business is this. That's what the balance sheet section shows. So it uses in the extended accounting equation assets, drawings, capital, and liabilities. Okay, let's have a look at what a balance sheet looks like. So we've got a basic balance sheet here as at 28th February 2018. So as stated, it shows the worth of the business at a specific time period. So this one shows the worth of the business on the 28th of February. So balance sheets basically looks like this, gentlemen. It's got your assets, and then it's got your equity and liabilities. And we all know by definition, assets is equal to owner's equity and liability. So basically, the top part of the balance sheets, the non-current assets and the current assets, will basically equal the bottom part of the balance sheets, the equity and the liabilities. That's how you'll know that your balance sheets is balanced and everything is okay. Non-current assets, please go and learn this, gents. Things like land and buildings, equipment, okay, things that you buy that make money for your business that will last for over 12 months. Current assets, things like bank, cash floats, okay, things that you can turn into liquid cash or you can use within 12 months. Equity and liabilities, okay, owner's equity. Okay, this capital at the end of the year, this capital at the end of the year, it's got a one here. That means you need to go work it out somewhere. So here's the one for capital, and I'll show you how to work it out just now. Okay, so even when you're writing your tests, your exams, just remember that in the balance sheets, the capital at the end of the year needs to be worked out in a separate sheet and then brought back in here. Okay, and then finally, you've got your non-current liabilities, things like your loans, okay, things like your mortgage bond. Mortgage bond is if you buy a house and you paid over, let's say, 20 years, you're paying a mortgage, okay? So that's something that you owe that you'll pay over 12 months. Then your current liabilities would be things like your creditors, people that you buy on credit from, okay? You want to pay them within 12 months. And as I said, gentlemen, your assets here at the top is equal to your equity and liabilities. So basically, this figure that's going to be up here, or total assets here, or equal to total equity and liabilities down at the bottom. Okay, so how do you work out this note to the balance sheets when you're calculating capital? So basically, to calculate capital, you first take your opening capital balance. This will be given to you on your trial balance. It will tell you that capital, in brackets, opening capital balance. You'll take that figure, you'll add, it's a plus sign, gentlemen, okay? You add your profit for the year. Where do you get this profit from there? Yes, from your income statements. Income statements has net profit at the end of the year. Okay, right at the bottom. So before you do a balance sheet in your test or exam, you need to make sure that you complete the income statement first so that you can get the profit for the end of the year. You then subtract. Okay, subtract your drawings. So that's money that you've taken out. Okay, money that you've taken out as an owner for your own personal use. And then finally, you'll get your capital figure. Okay, and that's the capital that goes in here. Capital at the end of the year, not one. Okay, thank you, gentlemen.